So there's a very recent event where a senior male scientist resigned because of very controversial remarks he made about women scientists being crybabies. There are situations that become very, very emotional in a lab. You have worked so long on something and something happens and it's destroyed. In my opinion, you're allowed to cry. I don't care if you're a man or a woman. That is a reason to cry. People are passionate in science. That's the ironic thing. People are so passionate about their work. They spend all of their waking hours working on this. Yet they're not allowed to cry if something goes wrong or something bad happens or even if something good happens. I cried when I learned how my paper got into Science magazine. I still remember that. And I think that women, not all women, but some women are more open to that. It's a movement that is not really started yet, but needs to start about bringing more positive emotion. By positive emotion, I mean real emotion, authentic emotion into the practice of science. Because as you know, the stereotype is closed, unemotional, it's just data, it doesn't matter. But the truth is that all scientists are passionate about their ideas and what they're doing. And that leads to passionate emotions that could include crying or laughing or celebrating. And I know lots of scientists that do show those emotions, but the stereotype is, and perhaps the old guard, is that shut down kind of thing. And the squelching of any show of emotion. So I certainly have had emotional situations in my lab where I had to say difficult things to people, and there have been tears shed. And I have to say that I've had a journey myself in learning how to deal with that. At first, it's like, I don't want you to cry because if you cry, I will cry, and that's terrible. So I tried not to have them cry. But my approach now is, look, that's natural. If you need to cry, you cry. It's just part. It doesn't show anything weak or strong. It's just part of the emotion that's coming out. And I understand that because I'm saying something that may be difficult for you to hear. And I can see that. And, my tagline is scientists are people too, and we have emotions. And I think we need to acknowledge that. So I think it's appropriate that scientist stepped down. I think that represents something that we need to move away from in science and embrace the fact that scientists are people and they have emotions and that we're very passionate people. And so crying can happen. I don't care if you're a man or a woman.